Hey gang, back with another video for you today. Guess who I have on the channel?
Hello, how are you?
It's Rachel. She loves our delicious fragrances.
Always.
And today we have a really delicious and spicy one called Vanille Paradox from a brand called Le Parfum de Rosine, mm-hmm. launched in 2019. We're going to review this one for you. Plus, we're going to do a giveaway of one full bottle of Vanille Paradox for a subscriber of this channel from the USA. So if you're curious to find out about this fragrance, please stay tuned. Thanks so much for tuning in. This is Sebastian with Smelling Great Fragrance Reviews. If this is your first time landing on this channel and you love watching fragrance reviews, finding out about new fragrances, discovering new brands, and of course participating in giveaways, please click the subscribe button below and also click the bell so you'll be notified for future videos and giveaways. So what have you been up to, Rachel?
Life has been good. You know me, I'm just baking cookies and food styling and salsa dancing.
And being recognized for my videos.
Yes!
Out in public.
I just had my first experience being famous. Thank you, Seb. I was in LA and a friend was just introducing me to another friend and she said, hey, I've seen you like online reviewing perfume on Seb's channel. And I was like, oh my God, it's so nice to meet you.
It's funny
it's
when that happens, huh?
Yeah, it was the best. So thank you.
Good experience.
My moment of fame was fantastic.
Well, so do you like vanilla, right?
I do. I love vanilla.
We did a top 20 vanilla fragrances video.
Yeah, I think we could safely say that I love vanilla.
You do love. And you did end up picking a spicy one for the number one spot.
Uh-huh, that's true.
You did. It was one of their fragrances.
It was.
Atelier d'Or's Lune Feline.
Yep,
that's the one. Yeah. So this one actually has similarities to me. So this mm-hmm. is Vanille Paradox from a brand called Le Parfum de Rosine, launched in 2019. Perfumer is Delphine Lebeau. Style is considered aromatic, spicy, and or your oriental fragrance. It is unisex because I think this is a very masculine vanilla because of the aromatic, spicy touches. Yep. EDP concentration, $170 for 100 ml, and I really love the color, and I think it fits the style of fragrance we're talking about. It's a vanilla, and I find vanilla to be this color. I don't know. I visually see vanilla being this color. What do you think?
Even like a darker. Yeah, darker? Absolutely.
Yeah. So for notes here in Vanille Paradox, you got juniper at the top with rosemary and mm-hmm. grapefruit. In the heart, you have rose, angelica, cardamom, and cedar.
Yes.
And in the base, you have vanilla, musk, and ambroxan. Mm-hmm. So we experienced this a couple times, and what we got was a very spicy concoction, right?
Yes.
Do you find the vanilla in here to be the gooey variety, or do you find it the dry variety?
I definitely think that it's the dry variety. Almost if it was ground, like the actual whole pod of the vanilla is mm-hmm. a lot more what I smell.
That's exactly what I was thinking. It's not the kind of vanilla, like a drippy kind of gooey.
Nope.
What do you think about the start? Is it like a very spicy?
I actually think it ends a little bit more with like the stronger spice. I think it ends with like a good note of cedar, which I think you said that it's a little bit more of like it could be a masculine fragrance.
Yeah.
I think that that's actually where that comes in. But I think it starts a little bit lighter, a little bit just like more on the vanilla side, and ends a little bit more with a spicy influence.
Interesting. Yeah, that's exactly what I got. But what I think this fragrance is a lot for me is not only vanilla, but cardamom. It is so cardamom prominent that if you like cardamom, you might want to think about this because it's almost like battling it out with the vanilla of which note is the dominant note in here. I get big doses of cardamom and it is absolutely delicious.
Yes.
If I was to do a cardamom fragrances video, this would definitely go on there because it is so cardamom heavy.
Yeah.
And I think that's also why it adds this dryness to the fragrance, don't you think?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely, because it's the seed of the cardamom that I believe that we're smelling.
And you're familiar with cardamom, right?
I am. It's actually one of my favorite spices to cook with. So I love cooking with cardamom seeds.
You do?
So, yeah, I do. Absolutely. Even
have I ever told you my mom used to put a pan on the stove and then drop some seeds on it and then just by themselves, and you let it like kind of heat up and then the smell just totally takes over the house.
Wow,
to me that reminds me of this because that smell is so amazing.
Yeah.
It's an awesome, awesome.
It's like so nostalgic as well.
It is?
It's amazing, yeah.
Do you know in the Middle East that sometimes they use that cardamom seed in coffee, like in really dark, heavy coffee?
I didn't know that.
Yeah, so if you ever have the opportunity to try Middle Eastern Turkish coffee,
try
it with cardamom.
Okay.
Anyway, going back to this fragrance. So the fragrance does have a little bit rose in the heart, and it does get a little floral from the angelica, but the angelica is not necessarily in your face. What's in your face here in the heart is that cardamom.
Yeah.
It's totally the cardamom. And then the vanilla is really like dominantly appears in the base. There's that little bit of musk in there. And of course, the ambroxan does add a little bit of a sexy touch in here as well, which makes it really, really yummy. Shall we try some on you?
Yeah, please.
And the thing about this is it sprays so amazing, as you can see here. It's a great sprayer.
It is a great sprayer.
Mmm, it's so good.
Yeah, it really, really is.
This is the kind of fragrance that actually has big projection. It's not subdued. It has great, great sillage. So be easy on the trigger with this one. So if you spray, like, let's say 10 sprays of this, you are going to choke people yes. around you, and you're going to leave a massive trail. Even with like 6 sprays, I think 3 to 4, 5 max sprays with this one is it. And usually I don't like to talk about performance with a fragrance because it's all, you know, subjective to me. But here, this has great, great performance. It's a cloud. It's a big cloud, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
You know what? We forgot to mention the top, the notes at the top. The juniper and rosemary is what's giving it the aromatic touch. But you know what? It carries over to the heart with the cardamom. Because anytime I see cardamom, juniper, rosemary, and rosemary in notes, it's an aromatic experience. And this is exactly what this fragrance is. But the juniper and rosemary at the top give it like a greenish touch, doesn't
it? Yeah, which I love. And what I love about it is actually if you took all of those components and you use them together as well in like a cooking dish, like across the board, I just think that those things are very harmonious.
Okay. It works together very well.
It's a beautiful blend.
So do you think we have a winner here?
I personally believe that we do.
We do, yes.
We personally love it.
We love it. And what do you think of the name Veni Paradox?
I love it.
You do?
It's gorgeous. Yeah, I love the way it rolls off your tongue.
Paradox.
Yeah.
What do you think of the color of the bottle?
I love the mustard bit of it. Like, I love, like, yeah, I love the darker, deeper yellow, rougy bit of it. Yeah.
So they launched 4 fragrances. Each one has a beautiful, deep color like this. There's a blue one, there's a pink one. And I can't remember the 4th one, what color it was. But I really love this. And I like the idea of this fragrance. And they had reached out to me and asked me if I want to review this fragrance. And they were going to send me the bottle. So this is what they sent me. And of course, they did also send me the giveaway prize. So we do have that giveaway here on the channel as well. Please make sure you're subscribed to participate in the giveaway. Please put a comment down. Let us know what your favorite vanilla fragrance is and what you liked about our review. Please put that down and please put your state. And good luck with the giveaway. Other than that, guys, if you have any questions or comments, please let us know. Put it down in the comment section. Have any questions for Rachel, also do that as well. Hopefully she'll be back for more reviews.
I'll be back.
She does love her gourmands, and hopefully we'll have a few more coming up soon. Please like this video. Please share it. Follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, and I'll be back with more videos very soon. Have a good one. Goodbye.
Bye.